Hey, what is up, guys? How's going? It's your boy, the sweaty palm tree. The Krappy Crafter here. Yeah, I used to be the sweaty palm tree, but now I am Krappy Crafter and I haven't changed my skin. I know, but it is all red. So, yeah, guys, welcome to another new episode of Simple Redstone Build Tutorials. So, in the previous episode, guys, we went ahead and built a simple wool farm that you can see right behind me. But today in this video, my friend, we are going to extend that wool farm and make it a little bit more faster. By faster, I mean about 50 to 70% faster. What the hell is wrong with you, Steve? Go away, there are plenty of space. So yeah, guys, today in this video we are going to build a wool farm that is faster than most of the wool farm that you can find in the YouTube. Hello, little cow, you want something? I don't have anything. Go away. So yeah, guys, today in this video we are going to build the wool farm that you can see right behind me, my friend, and it is the most efficient and fastest wool farm that you can find in this YouTube. Or let me know if you found a faster one. But yeah, guys, with all that said, let's just start let me just show you guys how it works. So the question is, what is a wool farm? So a wool farm is basically a farm that automatically shears your sheep and collects all the loot inside a chest. So this right here, my friend, is the basic or the traditional version of the wool farm. So this farm right here works when this sheep eats a grass block and then turns it into a dirt block. So as soon as the dirt block turns into a, as soon as the grass block turns into a dirt block, this observer will notice and then power this dispenser, which has a shear in it, and then that shear will, you know, shear this sheep and collect the wool inside this chest. But guys, this wool farm is actually quite slow because the sheep has to wait until the grass grows back to this dirt block. So the sheep has to wait until the grass grows into, the dirt block turns into a grass block, so that he can wait. So today in this video, my friend, we are going to upgrade this farm in a way that our sheep, you know, it doesn't have to wait until this grass grows into the grass block. This dirt block turns into a grass block, so he doesn't need to wait anymore in order to eat the grass. He can eat whenever he wants to, and whenever he eats grass, he will be seared by our dispenser. So yeah, guys, this right here is the upgraded version of the traditional wool farm, and this wool farm, my friend, can produce wool around 50 to 70% faster compared to our traditional wool farm. So how it works is that, as you can see, this farm has a grass block, and on top of that grass block there is a tall grass. And if you don't know, sheep can actually eat tall grass. So if the sheep eats the tall grass, he won't eat the grass block itself and turn it into a dirt block. So if we keep bone milling this grass block, it will produce tall grasses and ferns, and our sheep only will eat this tall grass and will grow his hair back. So as soon as he grows his hair back, he will be sheared and all his wool will be stored inside this chest. So as you can see, there are 62 wool already inside this chest, and while this wool farm has only 32 wool, and both of them are running for about, I think, 45 to 50 minutes. So yeah, guys, as you can see, this farm is twice as fast as our traditional wool farm. So yeah, guys, today in this video, my friend, my CP friend, so my friend, how we doing? Let me give you a kiss. We are going to upgrade, we are going to upgrade that farm and make it this ugly bastard looking thing, which is fast as hell, man. So with all that said, let's just straight jump into building, shall we?
Okay, guys, now let's just start by placing two chests on the ground just like this. So one, two, then go ahead and grab yourself a hopper. Then crouch down and connect the hopper with the chest, just like this. So make sure this hopper is funneling towards this chest. Now go ahead and crouch down and place a rail on top of this hopper just like this. And on top of this rail, we are going to place a minecart with hopper. So it should look like this. And if you don't know, minecart hopper can actually collect items which are on top of a block, which our normal hopper can't collect. So after that, just go ahead and surround this minecart with solid blocks or any other block of your choice, just like this. So it should look like this. Now once you do this, just go ahead and grab yourself a dispenser and place the dispenser facing towards this minecart with hopper, just like this. So make sure this dispenser is facing towards this minecart. Now go ahead and place some solid blocks around this dispenser, just like this, and then place a grass block just like this. Now just go ahead and fill the dispenser with as many bone meal as you can, because guys, this bone meal is going to this bone meal dispenser will bone meal this grass block and will produce tall grasses. Now guys, grab yourself an observer and place it on top of this dispenser facing towards that grass block. So place an observer on top of this dispenser which is facing towards the grass block. So make sure the face of this observer is towards this grass block right here. Now guys, go behind this observer and grab yourself two hoppers and connect those two hoppers with the dispenser just like this, and then go on top of this hoppers and place a chest on top of the hopper just like this. So we added this line of hopper so that you can fill the dispenser whenever the dispenser runs out of bone meal. After that guys, grab yourself a redstone dust and place it on top of this hopper just like this, so it can power our dispenser whenever our observer notices something odd in front of it. After that guys, come to this side and grab yourself another dispenser and place it on top of this block facing towards this grass block and fill the dispenser with shears, because guys, this dispenser will shear our sieve whenever the sieve eats the grass. But guys, keep in mind that every time the shears shear a sieve, it will lose some durability. So make sure to fill this dispenser with as many shears as possible. Now guys, we are going to connect this dispenser with our observer. So just grab yourself two solid blocks and place it like this, and then place two redstone dust on top of these solid blocks just like this. So now our observer is connected with two of our dispenser just like this. So now our observer can power two of our dispensers, one of them being the bone meal one and another one is the shearing one. Okay, now guys, grab yourself a bone meal and then bone meal this grass block just like this. So if I bone meal this grass block, it will produce a tall grass just like this, and if I break this tall grass, as you can see, our observer will notice and it will trigger our dispenser to fire more bone meals. So as long as you are having bone meal inside your dispenser, your farm will keep producing tall grasses. So make sure to fill the dispenser with as many bone meal as you can. But guys, there is a chance that bone milling this grass block sometimes spawns a flower, and if it spawns a flower, our sheep will not eat the flower, but instead will eat the grass block and turn it into a dirt block, making your farm to stop working. So guys, we are going to make another contraption that going to break this flower. So grab yourself a sticky piston, make sure it's a sticky piston and not a regular piston, and then place it on this block just like this, facing towards this grass block. So this sticky piston will push our grass block and break our flower on top of it. Now guys, to make the thing automatic, we're going to place an observer facing towards this grass block just like this. So every time the sieve eats this grass block, our observer will notice and will power our sticky piston, and then the sticky piston will Now push this grass block and break the flower. Now guys, to power the sticky piston, we are going to place some blocks underneath it, just like this, connecting to our observer, just like this. And then we are going to connect it with redstone, just like this. So when the sheep eats this grass block, our sticky piston will push it and break the flower on top of it. But as you can see guys, this is now turned into a clock because our observer is noticing two updates in front of it. So it's powering our sticky piston twice. So to break this this clock, we're going to remove this redstone dust and break this block right here. And we're going to place a regular piston. Make sure it is a regular piston and not a sticky piston. So we are going to place a regular piston on top of this chest, just like this. So make sure this regular piston is facing upwards. Now grab yourself a sand or a dirt block or a gravel block, not a dirt block, and place it on top of this piston, just like this. So if I become a sheep and eat this grass, as you can see, as soon as this block updates, our observer will notice and power this block, and this sand block will power this redstone dust, and this redstone dust will power this normal piston, and this normal piston will send this sand block flying and will prevent our observer from sending the second pulse to our sticky piston. So as soon as you can see, if I can show you guys again, so if I remove this block, as you can see, it is now sending only one pulse to our sticky piston, so that our sticky piston just don't pull this grass block back and forth forever. So yeah guys, this is a simple contraption that breaks that clock. And the final thing guys you have to do is to connect our sticky piston with the bone milling dispenser. And to do so, just grab yourself an observer and face it towards the sticky piston, just like this. So make sure the red dot is facing towards this way. Now guys, just go ahead and grab yourself one solid block and place it behind the observer, just like this, and place a redstone dust on top of it. And guys, that should be all. Your sticky piston is now connected with our bone milling dispenser, and your farm is in a way done. And finally, come to the front side and place two more grass blocks connecting to this observer and this sand block, so that our grass can spread whenever this block turns into a dirt block. And finally, make a chamber so that our sheep can't escape. So make it at least two blocks tall so that our sheep won't be able to jump through that cage. So it should look like this. So yeah guys, your farm is in a way done. And the last thing you want to do is to bone mill this grass block so you can get the tall grass so that our sheep can eat. And let's just put all the bone meal over here. And finally, get a sheep inside this chamber. You can use wheats to lure them inside this chamber, but as I am in creative mode, I'm going to use an egg, just like this. And guys, your farm is now all set. So this is the advanced version of the whole farm, which is around 50 to 70% faster. As you can see, it's pretty fast, my man. So yeah guys. And guys, some people say if you place a light source on top of a grass block, the grass actually spreads faster. So you can place a light source on top of this grass block so it can spread faster. So as you can see, our farm is now working pretty fast, and we already got 4 wool in no time. And my friend, that should be all for our today's tutorial, and I hope you like the video. And if you do not forget to hit the like button, and also take this lantern. And also, if you are new to this channel, do not forget to give me a sub. That would help me a lot. And yeah guys, if you are having any problems while making this farm, or if you have any question regarding this farm, let me know in the comments and I'll be more than glad to reply them. So yeah guys, that should be all for our today's video, and I will see you guys in the next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.